Before a new electrical installation can be connected to an electrical supply, the electrical worker must complete a series of tests to verify the safety and correct operation of that installation. Section 8 of ASNZS 3000 outlines the list of mandatory tests required for verification of an installation. As an electrician, you need to be familiar with each of these tests. You must carry out these mandatory tests following a visual inspection of the installation. This video will examine the electrical tests undertaken in the verification process, how you must perform these tests, and the results required for each of these tests. The test equipment used in this video will be a multimeter and an insulation resistance, IR, tester. As in any testing procedure, you must check the instrument for correct operation before testing commences. We will also use a trailing lead to extend the reach of the test equipment, allowing for connection to wiring terminations at a distance from the main switchboard. The information in this video is for training purposes only. Any electrical work should be conducted only by qualified electricians and under the appropriate level of supervision, following all work health and safety regulations. Main earth. Following the testing sequence flowchart, figure 8.1, in section 8 of ASNZS 3000, the first test performed is resistance of the main earth conductor. You must use a multimeter set to the low ohm range for this test. In most domestic installations, the main earth conductor length will be just a few meters from the main switchboard to the earth stake. The main earthing conductor must have a resistance of no more than 0.5 ohms. Given the cross-sectional area and length of the main earth conductor, the actual resistance should be negligible. To conduct this test, remove the main earth tail from the earth bar in the main switchboard to eliminate any parallel paths that could give false readings. When using a trailing lead to reach one end of the conductor, you need to record the trailing lead's resistance and subtract that from the reading obtained. The test probe is placed on the earth stake to include the earth clamp connection in this test. Once verified, you can reconnect the main earth at the switchboard. At this stage, you should verify the equipotential conductors and structural earthing conductors. Remember, equipotential bonding conductors cannot have a resistance of more than 0.5 ohms. Protective earthing conductor resistance values must be compared to Table 8.2 of ASNZS 3000. Protective earthing conductors. Next, each protective earthing conductor must be tested and verified. Table 8.2 in ASNZS 3000 gives maximum resistance values for protective earthing conductors of various sizes and protective device ratings. All protective earths must be verified. Before undertaking this test, you need to remove the MEN link. Disconnect any protective earth conductor with a parallel path back to the earth bar to avoid false readings. Then compare the resistance readings of protective earthing conductors with the maximum permissible values in Table 8.2. Insulation resistance test. To conduct the insulation resistance test between all live conductors, actives and neutral, connected together and the earth, you need to set the IR tester to 500 volts. All circuit protection devices and switches should be on for this test. With multiple way lighting switch circuits, you must apply an insulation resistance test to both switching positions to include all circuit conductors in the IR test. After the initial test, you should toggle multiple way switches and conduct the test again. For a test to pass, the IR reading must be above 1 megaohm, as stated in ASNZS 3000, which is the minimum acceptable value. However, for a new installation, the insulation resistance reading should ideally be hundreds of megaohms. If the IR tester returns a poor reading, indicating a fault, you can switch off the RCBOs individually until the fault no longer registers. Readings can also be taken individually from the load side of isolated protection devices to identify the faulty circuit. New equipment such as electric ranges can return poor insulation resistance readings due to the element's low internal resistance to earth. If so, you should temporarily disconnect the range and test the circuit conductors for compliance. You must conduct an insulation resistance test between all active and neutral consumer mains conductors and all active and neutral submain conductors. This is done separately with these cables disconnected from the installation to prevent damage to any electronic equipment installed. Polarity testing and correct circuit connection. For correct polarity, you must verify all mains, submains, and final subcircuit cables. You need to confirm that single pole switches switch active only, and Edison screw light fittings are polarised correctly. You must also verify socket outlets, protection devices, and fixed appliances for correct connection and switching operations. Next, complete a point-to-point test for all active and neutral conductors using a multimeter set to the low ohm range. Record the resistance of each circuit active conductor to confirm the circuit's resistance is low enough to satisfy fault loop impedance requirements and compare the resistance values with table 8.2. Remember, when using a trailing lead for testing, you must deduct its resistance from any reading taken. Verification of operation residual current devices, RCDs. You can test the operation of RCDs and RCBOs only when the power is connected. Once you have conducted the mandatory tests and deemed the installation safe for connection, you can reconnect the MEN. Neutral conductors are not subject to fault loop requirements. Still, their resistance values should be compared with the associated active conductor for verification purposes. As part of the verification procedure, a short circuit test between active and neutral conductors is performed with a multimeter. Remember, any connected loads in the circuit will give a reading between active and neutral, so these should be temporarily disconnected for this test. The meter should return an open circuit reading for this test. Earth fault loop impedance test. As with the testing of RCD or RCBO function, A fault loop impedance test is conducted with the power connected to the installation. Once power is applied to an installation, it is recommended this test be carried out, as it will confirm the validity of the supply authority's connection, as well as the installation. All test readings taken need to comply with the requirements of Section 8 of AS/NZS 3000. Any faults found during testing must be rectified before power can be connected to the installation. And now you know how to perform the required verification tests before applying power to an installation.